What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLean, and I'm a music producer. So today, doing Miley Cyrus' Tiny Desk. I saw that she posted it yesterday, and I know it's going to get taken down probably really fast just because Plastic Hearts only lasted like a day. If you want to check that out, that's up on the Patreon now. But I figured, why not? You know, honestly, I loved the album, and I want to see what she does here. And I've been doing a ton of Tiny Desks lately, so I figured it'd fit right in. Also, I got my zebra mug back. Whoop. So a bunch of things like that. Before we get started though, as always, please give me a like, give me a subscribe if you enjoy the channel, and I'll probably plug Patreon again like midway through. So anyways, let's jump in. Let's go. All right, so this is Miley Cyrus Tiny Desk concert. He did acoustic, sweet. Sounds so good. I want to take a breath, that's true. You know, I've noticed this with some of the Tiny Desks lately, especially the ones since quarantine started. They've really upped the quality, and it's because they have the ability to. You know what I mean? They can run everything through prior. They can even work on a track a little bit prior, make it sound absolutely perfect, set up something, and everything just really falls into place. So now it's kind of sounding a little bit more like the record, you know? I look to you and I see nothing. Also, every time I hear this, I just hear, we can leave the Christmas lights up till, what is it, January or February? Let's go with February, because it's, no. It's January 30th. Eh. I'm all over the place. I look to you to see the truth. You live your life, you go in shadow. This too, it sits right in her range so well. She's not pushing, not doing anything too hard on this, and it's very obvious. Look at how relaxed she is as she does this. The woman Bon Jovi, I love it. Love it.
A stranger's light comes on slowly. A stranger's heart without a home. You put your hands into your head. And it smiles, cover your
eyes. This is sick. This is so sick, and you can tell it's live too, because like you can actually see the fluctuations. Everything moves with the mic, unless she just practiced like nonstop to try and make sure that everything was perfect, you know, in terms of like mic placement and everything like that. I mean, it's just, wow. We'll be right back. right, I'm ready to see what's next.
Thank you for having me, Tiny Desk.
I woke up in Montecito. I was thinking about my life. And the questions raise more questions, staring out into the night.
I just loved how this one gave me like an old folk feel, and it's because of the way that it's being played on the guitar. It's very like, not even old folk. It's like Stones, like No Expectations, like the, oh my gosh, how does that even go? Oh my gosh, wow, I can't even remember the lyrics right now, but I know that it's the same feel.
Yes, I want the golden G-string.
As it is. No expectations to pass through here again. Like that kind of a thing.
Put my hand into hellfire. I did it all to make you love me and to feel alive.
It's so cool whenever you do something like that and you just kind of play with it, and then you sort of, you know, it's almost like, I don't know if it's like the seventh or whatever that she hits, but it just kind of gives it a little bit more tension there when you're waiting for that root note, that I walk away, like whenever it comes down to that almost like home bass, you know, but you just create a little bit more tension than the listener thinks is gonna happen.
There are layers to this body, primal sex and primal shame. They told me I should cover it, so I went the other way. I was trying to own my power, still I'm trying to work it out. So the madman's in the big chair, and his heart's an iron vault. He says, if you can't make ends meet, honey, it must be a fault. We all focus on the winners and get blinded by their shine. Maybe caring for each other.
You know, it's the lyrical style too. That's what's so different here. It's even more like Kenny Rogers, or like Billy Joel, or like the Rolling Stones, you know, or any of those. It has almost like a storyline to it, or even like the Eagles, you know, which is so classic and so cool. And the reason I like it more than anything, and I think that's why this album stuck out to me, and I've been doing this with my stuff as well, stuff I've been writing, is it's more descriptive, and it's not so, there's like a thing in pop music where basically they say, you know, don't, it's like conformed to society just a little too much, because it's, everything has to be like, this is the way they want it. Everything has to be like ambiguous almost. You know what I mean? Like you're not really describing anything in particular. You're not, you know, using any pronouns like him, her, you know, or like she, which to the person that might be how it is, you know what I mean? And I just think it's like, it's really refreshing to hear something that's so descriptive and so metaphorically, I guess, sound and real, you know?
It's just to 1969.
Note on that last thing, the goal of that, the reason that the industry is like that and the reason that that's kind of the lyrical style that they push is because it does have a dog hair on me. is that it allows people to apply whatever they want to it, whatever meaning they want to the song. And so it just appeals to a wider audience, more people listen to it, and then, you know, more money, that kind of a thing. But then you lose the art, if you ask me. Absolutely killer.
Thank you so much. Prisoner, locked up, can't get you off my mind.
Absolutely love this song. Also, taking a quick second to plug my Patreon. If you want to go check it out, blocked videos. You guys get to vote on what I do next, put on YouTube, that kind of a thing. You can give me requests, all that stuff. There's a link down in the description. Please go check it out. Again, Plastic Hearts is up there. And there's like tons of exclusive content too. I also try and put everything up there first. So, and it helps support the channel. Means a ton. Oh, and a Discord. I have a Discord too. Go join the Discord. It's a lot of fun. We're doing karaoke on Sunday.
Lord knows I've tried a million times. Oh, no, why can't you just let me go?
I guess they're actually playing with a real band too. I don't know why I just like was still so focused on where she was. I wasn't even paying attention, but yeah, I guess there is a live band there. So it looks like they're in a nice studio. Sick. A great bridge, because you feel how it does. I was actually I've been meaning to talk about this just a little bit. So a lot of people, I did that Olivia Rodrigo driver's license reaction, and a lot of people are like, no, that's not a secondary chorus, that's just a bridge, you know, don't listen to them. It's a secondary chorus, and here's why. A bridge is an aside from the song. It's a separation from the song itself. There's no resolve in a bridge. A bridge creates tension and then brings you back. Whoops, I just hit that. And then brings you back to the chorus, the main part for the resolution. What happened in Olivia Rodrigo's song, and this is actually a perfect example of a bridge, because you feel how it just all of a sudden sets everything aside and moves into something that's creating more tension. You know, it's a little bit darker, or if the song is like in a minor key, you might move into like the relative major part of it. You know, so it kind of sets itself aside. But in like Olivia Rodrigo's Driver's License, it's interesting because it's one of the few songs that I've heard. Another one is John Mayer's My Stupid Mouth, that it has like what feels like a chorus and feels like a main hook until all of a sudden you hit this part and it's like, there's the real resolution. Oh my gosh, there it is. that's the real hook. That's what you've been building up to this entire song. That's why it's a secondary hook and not a bridge. Because then, you know, there's no, again, it's not creating tension. It just brings you into that really good feeling resolution. So that's why I call it a secondary chorus.
Won't you forget you when your love is the loudest? Oh, I can't control it. I can't control it. No, you keep making it harder to stay. I still can't run away. I gotta know why. Can't you let me go?
Such a pro. Listen to the control she has over her vocal. It's just unbelievable. So many people would kill for that kind of control over their vocal. I know I would.
You just let me go.
Also, I do want to say that kind of control over your vocal is something you only get from experience and from hard work, from touring, from doing it over and over and over again, from working with vocal coaches every day of your life. Like, you can get there. It just takes so, so, so much and so much work.
Thank you very much, NPR Tiny Desk.
Killer. Absolutely killer. So impressed. Anyways, thank you guys so much for hanging around. Really hope you enjoyed the video. That's pretty much everything. So until next time, catch y'all later.